When you leave here tonight, I need you to get your fine self in the mirror. I need you to get your handsome self in the mirror. I need you to get your tall, dark, and elegant self in the mirror. I need you to get in the closet, and I need you to get on your face, and I want you to say, God, they don't know, but you and I know how sick I am. I'm just going to keep it 1,000. I don't know what you think about me, but God know how dark I am. God know where I come from. I said, God, you know how dark I am. Fix it. Fix it before I break my wife. Fix it before she leaves. Create in me a clean heart, oh God. Humble my debt. Man, I remember when I got my life to Christ. And I remember when I started reading the Bible and studying. I remember I used to walk around like I ain't like my daddy. My daddy didn't, he wasn't even my life playboy. He all around here with these women. I ain't nothing like my daddy. And I was at Doc's getting me a fish whisk with the cheese and the large fry and the lemonade. And Pastor, when I was getting it, I ain't have a lot of money. So I started talking to the girl like, you know what I'm saying? I started spitting that game. You know what I'm saying? I had $5, the meal was 10. I was like, you, hey, what's up, girl? Are you from the west side, from the south side? And after I got the meal, my grandmother said to me, boy, you just like your daddy. I said, what? This is my grandma. I said, what? She said, yeah, you just like your. I said, I don't even know my daddy. She said, well, you just like him. Huh? God said, son, right now is sin. If you keep playing with it, it's about to be transgression. Listen to me, I'm not here to judge you. I'm here to tell you my story. I'm not trying to tell you what to do, but I cried out and said, God, the one person that loved me to life, I'm about to lose her on some flirting stuff. I ain't even sleeping with nobody, I'm about to lose her. David's getting a little older, and David's transgressions it's starting to become public now. All of a sudden, the David that was a man after God's own heart, He now sleeping with Bathsheba, and that ain't even the problem. The problem is the man who looked after him, the man that was his bodyguard, the man, his armor bearer, the man that wouldn't even go sleep with his wife to look after David. David said, take his life. Oh, no, I didn't went from sex to now you a murderer. Oh, you better hear what I'm saying. Satan ain't gonna stay in the closet for long. He ain't gonna stay in the house forever. At some point, he gonna come out. We can do this the easy way. God is saying, we can do this the easy way. You can cry out. We can do this the easy way. You can say, have mercy upon me, God. We can do this the easy way. I already know where you come from. I already know your sins. I don't even know why you're trying to act like you ain't got none. Oh, can I talk to the saints today who trying to act like you don't know that you got sins, that you don't? Can I talk to the saints? You run around here talking to these kids at 18 because you 64 and your stuff don't work like it did when you were 16. You talking to them like you lived like that when you wasn't acting like that when you was 18. You 64 now. Help me, somebody. You 64. You ain't got the same desires you had when you was 20. But when you was 21, you wasn't acting saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost. Have you lost your mind? They got it from you. I'm talking about she fast. You just didn't get caught. Don't act like you better than me. You just didn't get caught. You were doing your dirt too. You just didn't get pregnant. You just had somebody in your family that was powerful and they was able to hide your stuff. Cry out is the point where you acknowledge to God, you're sovereign. I need help. But what we'd rather do is come out and look like we good instead of really being good. What we really rather do, it ain't nothing wrong with looking good, but we spending so much time trying to prove to people. People say, E.T., bro, why are you so free? Like, why are you so? Because one day I woke up and realized I am a sinner. And that if I'm going to get saved, it's only because of the... Hurry up. We ain't got a lot of time. Let's go back. I want to, if I could just real quick, I just want to teach. David gets to a point in his life where he like, shoot, I messed up. Number one, this is why this one transgression, this one it go from sin to transgression. Number one, you the king, you should have been in battle. No. I want to help somebody. If you know you're a king and you're not where you're supposed to be, before it turned into that, I want you just to confess to God right now and just say, God, I'm over her house. We ain't done none yet, but I shouldn't even be at her house. Help me, Jesus. I'm on the phone with her. I know we shouldn't even be on the phone. How we even get on the phone? I got to get off the phone with her. Because what it's going to turn into was David wasn't where he was supposed to be doing what he was supposed to be doing. He was a king. He should have been at battle. He should have been at war. But instead, he at home. Let me tell you something. While you playing like you don't know your transgression, the devil know him. And he ain't playing like he don't know him. Let me tell y'all something. This thing, Pastor, this thing so bad. My right-hand man, CJ, he came to me once. And he was like, yo, E, her, be careful. I was like, be careful what? He was like, I know your type. I was like, we ain't never had no conversation. He said, we don't have to. I've been with you for 15 years. Be careful is all I said. I didn't say you did nothing wrong, but I know. I know. Oh, y'all not hearing me. The old me would have been when Dee Dee said it to me at 19 or 20. She might help me. I should have just took the pride down and I should have just said, you know what, Dee Dee, you right. But instead, I try to act like I didn't know what she was talking about. Now David got to a point where he on the roof and Bathsheba just happened to be taking a bath and she just happened to be naked and her door just happened to be open, the shades just wide open. Y'all say, how you gonna do, my man? That's why I said the devil know what y'all, and he just happened to use his authority. I'm trying to tell you, God gives us so many opportunities. God gives us so many chances. He say warning that check some of y'all right now. You got the check engine light on and you driving acting like you didn't put tape over that joker. Just don't want to see it. That joker say check engine light. That joker blinking, it's red, yellow. And you just gonna put tape over that joker. You just like, ain't nothing wrong. That joker on low. Yo, it's so low. That joker passed the E. It's on the other side. You on fumes. The man of God, the warrior. Saul killed thousands. Dave killed 10,000. The warrior. The giant slayer. The transgressor. Huh? Nah, he didn't call her over. They didn't went from talking to nah. They had one sexual encounter and now she's pregnant. Can I just say this to y'all? Man, I'm still hurt. I'm just like, wow, God, the price that I paid for some of this sin, it wasn't even worth it. The price I paid, if I knew this was gonna happen because I did that, I would have never done that. Is somebody else, can somebody, are you, am I the only one? Talk back to me. Have some of you paid too much for sin? You paid too much? It just cost too much? You didn't get out the deal what you thought you was going to get? And so the man of God is set up tonight. He set us up tonight to start crying out. And now she's pregnant. And David said, tell her husband to come home and sleep with her so I can act like that's his job. We just get out of hand, y'all. We gotta cry out, Daddy, stop us. My man was so strong. He loved Dave so much. He was like, bruh, how in the world could I ever go sleep with my wife in the middle of battle? God gave David out. He gave him an out. Like, let it go. Just go ahead and confess. Let it go. Nope. Send him back out to war. And when y'all send him out to war and y'all get in the middle of battle, y'all all retreat and leave him up front by himself so he can get killed. You the apple of God's eye. We are all the apples of God's eye. But at some point, we got to stop seeing where it's at. We just seeing. We can't let it turn into transgress. And David said, I know how to fix it. God, he cried out, Lord, have mercy on me. According to thy loving kindness, according to the multitudes of thy tender birth, blot out my transgressions. Come on, let's go. Let's walk through this. We don't got a lot of time. Let's walk through this. Verse 2, watch David. He's giving us the blueprint of how to cry out. wash me thoroughly from my iniquities. Cleanse me from my sin. It's a difference. Sin is what I was born with. Iniquity is what I fostered. Iniquity is what I built personally with my decisions and my personality and my character. Sin is what I came into earth with. Iniquity is tailor-made. It's what I personally like. When I told the story about CJ, somebody's like, no, no, it's okay. I know where my sins are and I ain't playing with them no more. And so when I see my sin, I'm like, deuces. No, I do corporate work. ET, we got a happy hour afterwards. I came to speak. I gotta go. Oh, you can't come to the happy hour? Mm-mm. Mm-mm. That joker may not be happy if I go to that joker. That joker might not be happy. I turn up in that joker. My father was strung out on crack for 14 years. My uncle died of cirrhosis of the liver. For whatever reason, the men in my family, they can't do drugs recreationally. Oh, listen to me very closely. You better get to a point where you know your sins and you got a plan to come about them jokers. Don't be playing games. You better have you a little bit. You better have you a sin plan, iniquity plan. Hey, oh, you better hear what I'm saying. There's nothing wrong with temptation. It is the yielding that is sin. Oh, talk back to me. Come on, how many of y'all got a problem with yielding sometimes? Let me be real. Let's make some noise for that. Come on, let me hear you make some noise. You got a yielding problem. Here's what I discovered. The more you're honest with God and the people that are your accountability people, the less you got to worry about sinning. Hallelujah, praise God. Listen to me. This is something I always tell people. I said, this is how I know I love my wife. Because I went to an HBCU. And God has blessed the sister. Oh, you missing what I'm saying? Oh, my eyes work. All my stuff work. Oh, you missed what I just said. I don't have no deficiencies. You know what I'm saying? Amen. Come on. And my wife ain't got none. Oh, talk back to me. Huh? We acting like we get married and there's everybody else ugly after that. Ain't nobody else fine. Ain't no more temptation. We good. We got married and in jail. We about to be translated now. Come on, stop playing with sin. Huh? I'm telling you, everything Pastor Hannah said, it's ours. Make that sound. But a part of that sound is confess. A part of that sound, when you're making that sound, say, wash me thoroughly. Cleanse me of my sins. For I acknowledge, I'm just trying to show you the cry out blueprint. For I acknowledge my transgression and my sin is present while I preach. I got more problems now than I had before. I ain't have a lot of choices when I was broke. I ain't had as many options before I was number one in the world. Talk back to me. I got more problems now than I had when I was. I'm not trying to pretend like I'm number one overcoming sin. That's a more worldly title. Even as I preach, Satan is like, when you get down, when you finish with Goliath, I'm going to wait for your butt. When you finish killing 10,000, I'm going to wait for you. When you finish praying, I'm going to wait for you. And at some point, David, I'm going to get you. At some point, David, I see how you looked at me. At some point, Samson, I know how strong you are. I know, but at some point, I'm going to have you in Delilah's bed. Oh, please, can you do me a favor before we leave? Can you just acknowledge it and stop faking like you don't know what it is? Can you stop acting like you so worried about what they think about you? I just want you to cry out. David said, for I acknowledge, I'm not stupid, I'm not dumb. I acknowledge my transgression and my sin is with me right now. With the five rocks, the stones, and the slingshot, his sin was before him. When he cut Goliath's head and he pulled that joker up. I'm here to tell you today that just because you're successful in Christ don't mean the devil ain't waiting for you.
What up, what up, what up? It's your boy, E.T. Flight Assessment 2.0. Look, I love the assessment so much that it took me to a whole nother level. Like, I'm telling y'all, y'all think I've always been here. I promise you, there was a time I was lost. I'm just being real. There was a time that I was just shooting. I didn't know what to aim for. Like, I didn't know. And so I wasn't making the money I'm making now. I didn't know, y'all. I had a gift, but I didn't really know what the gift was. I didn't know how to use it. I remember struggles in my marriage because I didn't know who I was, struggling with my kid. So the flight assessment was phenomenal because it changed my life. It gave me a sense of clarity that I never had before. Like, it showed me my value, and it showed me, like, how to market my value, how to understand my value, how to sell my value, like, how to put a price tag on what I was worth. I didn't know before. I was watching other videos, watching other people, mimicking other people, trying to do what other people were doing. It didn't work, y'all. And then, boom, this assessment showed me me. Now, I'm gonna be honest. While I love the assessment, it was on some PhD stuff. Like, it was like an advanced degree. So I took the flight assessment 2.0 and simplified it for you. Flight assessment now is a pilot, a flight attendant, a ground crew, air traffic control. Like, I simplified it with symbols and words that you can understand so that you can immediately take it and boom, and do something with it. You're going to be able to use it immediately. You're gonna figure out who you are, why you tick, what you do, and then you're gonna be able to, boom, take who you are and what you do and put it in the marketplace and make money. Listen to me very closely. Not only are you gonna figure out who you are, you're gonna figure out who everybody around you is, and guess what? You're gonna slow life down. You're gonna slow the game down, and you're gonna be able to do and be and have stuff you've never had before. So do me a favor, listen to me. In 15 minutes, your whole life is gonna change. Like, I revamped the whole thing. I made the investment. I studied this thing for 5-6 years. I studied you. I got it, y'all. I got it. It's gonna take 15 minutes. And in 15 minutes, you gonna know you like you've never known you before. You gonna have resources. You gonna have the people that's gonna be able to help you. You gonna be able to go, be, do, have everything you've ever dreamed of. You gonna speak with clarity. You gonna move with clarity. You gonna think with clarity. You gonna write with clarity. And that clarity is gonna open up doors that you never imagined that could be open. Are you hearing me? So I went from a YouTube sensation to the number one motivational speaker in the world. So I want you to do me a favor. Act right now. Don't think, don't overthink, right? Make the investment. Don't spend no money, make the investment. You're gonna get your money back. Click the button, register, sign up, and do me a favor. Bro, I promise you, when you do, after that 15 minutes, you are about to make the rest of your life the best of your life. It's your boy ET. The flight assessment has revolutionized my life and my family's life and my family's coming life. Let it revolutionize you and your family to come.